Jackson 5's recording of I Want You Back. It was their first release on Motown. After they left Motown, they became the Jacksons. Now they're going on tour for the first time in almost three decades and paying tribute to their brother Michael. Joining me now for a primetime exclusive, Tito, Jackie, Marlon and Jermaine Jackson. It's their first interview together since Michael's death. Welcome to you all.
Thank you. It's fantastic to
see you.
Great to see you.
It's a real thrill. You know, I grew up with your music. You know, I mean, the moment I hear that, I want to get up and start, but I won't because nobody wants to see that. But it's also, it's a bittersweet moment because seeing the four of you together without Michael, you know, for everyone that loved all you guys, a very bittersweet moment. But for you in particular, this was your brother. How does it feel for you going back on tour, on the road, and Michael's no longer here?
Well, we miss him. We're excited to keep the legacy going, the music going, but we miss him so much. But it's something that he would want us to do, is to keep it going. And I guess the challenge, right, guys, was trying to decide what music we were going to do. That was the biggest challenge.
And plus the fans wanted us to tour. You know, after getting so many emails from the fans around the world, I think we owe it to them as well to go out to perform for our fans. They want to sing the songs with us and entertain, so.
I think with the brothers, and each one of us might have, you know, our own reason of why, how we feel on stage without having our brother up there, because so many years we've always performed, and he was right there. So for me, you know, when I'm on stage, I think about, wow, Michael used to be right here, now he's no longer, but in spirit, he will be there with us.
Well, I agree with Marlon, what he was saying. And what's beautiful about this tour is we're going to be doing some of the venues that we played prior to Motown, like the Apollo Theater,
places
like
that.
We started there.
So many shows with Michael prior to I Want You Back in ABC. So
six shows a day.
Yeah.
Six shows a day. We know he'll be there with us.
Six shows a day. Is that right?
Yes.
We always trying to make it. Yes.
Now, tell me this. I mean, we'll come back to Michael a little later, but when you think of the Jacksons, I suppose the impression that everybody has is that you guys never really had a childhood. This thing exploded when you were young, and that you've all in some way been damaged by that fact, that you never had the chance to be normal. And yet, I've only just met three of you now. I've met Jermaine before. You seem remarkably undamaged on the outside. You seem happy, guys. I'm not looking at people and thinking you guys are damaged. So what is the truth about being a Jackson?
Well, what is abnormal? See, what is abnormal?
Well, that's a very good point.
You know, my theory on all of that is that I've always said that I think my father prepared us for manhood. You're only a child up to 18, but you got the rest of your life to be a man. And he prepared us to be men for that extra.
I mean, he's had a tough
40
rap.
Or 50 years. Yeah. You know, we're men.
Has he had a too hard a rap, your father? I mean, I've interviewed Jermaine, I've interviewed Latoya, Janet.
I feel so, for sure. Absolutely.
Yeah, because I can tell you now, I've done an interview with your mother, which is airing on Monday, which is an extraordinary interview. Mm-hmm. She's an extraordinary woman. But of the many things she said, which I found extraordinary, it was her defense of her husband, your father, which I found one of the most moving. And she was like, you know, when you guys grew up, where you grew up, you had a choice as parents. You let your kids run riot, go on the streets and get into trouble and end up maybe getting shot or jailed or whatever it may be. Or you got a grip of your children and you disciplined them and you gave them another life.
Exactly.
There's chores to do, yeah.
How do you honestly feel? I mean, do you feel your father went too far on occasion? Or do you now that you're older and you've had kids, some of you yourselves, do you get it?
I get it totally. You know, when you're a kid, sometimes you feel your father has gone too far because you're a kid. But now when you look back, he's done a wonderful job. You know, look where we are. I mean,
I think that, you know, when you have so many kids in the family, I mean, we are at you know, I have, what was it, 11 of us in the home in Gary, Indiana. Mm. So somewhere along the way, you got to have a grip on the family. And he saw something in the kid. Well, let me rephrase that. I'm going to put it. My mom saw something in her kids that my father did not see, which was they had some type of talent. And after convincing him over a few months that your kids do have talent, and once she did that and convinced him, then it was on for us because he wanted to make sure.
And when you say that, you know, as you sit here now, you're all in your late 50s, 60 in one. Well, I think you're the oldest, right?
Yeah, I'm the oldest. Yeah.
I've got to say, mate, you are weathering well.
Oh, thank you.
Well, how old are you, 60, 61?
61.
I mean, all of you. I mean, give me all your ages. Come on.
58.
61.
55.
57.
Right. I mean, you're all, I've got to say, guys, you are aging well. Like a fine bottle of Chateau Latour.
Oh, that's
you get, exactly. Exactly what I'm thinking. Again, I come back to your upbringing, because we can come to what happened next a little later. But do you think that when you see your father now, because he's such an extraordinarily iconic figure, I think, in American entertainment. Mm-hmm. He's the guy that has always had the mean, tough guy reputation, brutalizing his children, driving them to fame and fortune. And the more I talk to people around your family, the less I feel that. The more I feel like he just wanted you guys to come out of life well.
Exactly. He got behind us. He supported us.
And how do you get on with him now?
Great.
Very well. Yeah.
He kept us busy. You know, he used to work two jobs. And when he was away, we had cylinder blocks in our backyard. He would make us move them. I mean, we had hundreds of them. Mm-hmm. Move them from one side of the yard to the other side. That took all day. And after you get older and you realize what he was doing, he's keeping you out of the streets.
What are the values he instilled in you, do you think?
So many.
Respect other people's time. Yeah. You know,
being honest and doing what you're told to do exactly how you're told to do it. And just the discipline.
Your mother said to me that she, again, this is not airing till Monday, so it's slightly in reverse, but I think it's relevant. She said to me that she despairs of modern America in terms of parental control of children.
Exactly.
That now you can't do anything to discipline your kids without sometimes the kids ringing up and complaining about their own parents. She said unfairly. Obviously, sometimes it is fairly, and there is abuse out there and so on, but she felt strongly that there isn't enough discipline.
I don't think kids today respect adults as the way they did when we were coming up as kids.
Exactly.
And I think that's important. Mm-hmm. I see kids today, they don't, you know, step aside and let their elderly go in front of them or pass them over the doors. They have no sense of that. And that comes from inner house. You know, your parents instilling values and things of that nature in the kids. And it's not happening because sometimes the parents are too busy trying to be kids themselves.
Yeah, totally agree. Let's take a break, chaps. Let's come back and talk about a bit more about Michael. I want to know what plans you have for the tour, how you're going to remember him. There is a suggestion you can have. On the Victory Tour in 1984, performing Shake Your Body. That was the last time the brothers ever performed on tour together. That is my favorite Jackson song.
Oh, Shake Your Body?
Yeah, and I have shaken my body all over the world to that song in a terrible manner, certainly not in the way that you guys do. Here's what strikes me about you four. Even in the commercial breaks, you're just great mates, aren't you?
Yes.
Now, despite everything you've been through. Now, I'm supposed to be looking at these tormented, ruined souls destroyed by fame, fortune, you know. You're the Jacksons, apparently the most dysfunctional family out there. You know, here's a secret I've unraveled from interviewing half of you. You're no more dysfunctional than most families I know. In fact, if anything, you're less dysfunctional. Do you feel, you laugh when you hear that, but does it make you laugh when everyone else assumes you're so dysfunctional? Yeah, here I see four brothers getting on great.
They don't know us, right, Marlon?
They don't know us.
Is there anything weird about you, Marlon?
He's the funniest guy in the world right now. This guy right here.
Why did y'all sit me next to
you?
Do you ever have arguments? Do you ever have fights?
Of course.
When was the last time you actually physically fought?
Oh, that's fight.
We don't do that. We might put on some boxing gloves.
Who would win if you were to fight?
I would.
Yeah. Oh, you're all going. Well, you're all saying you win. Okay. Let's cut to the real story, the favorite Jackson song of them all. Tito?
Well, I like the old stuff, like I Want You Back in ABC, the Love You Save, the Motown stuff.
I love that. But here's the deal with this question. This is, you can only have one song.
One song, I Want You Back.
I'll be there.
Since Jackie took one of mine, I'm going to say, to go to Jermaine.
Marlon, because you're going to say the same thing I say.
Really?
Just go.
Okay, I like Maybe Tomorrow.
Yeah, great call. Yes. Cool. Jermaine?
No, Never Can Say Goodbye.
Really?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You see, there's so many to choose from, aren't there? Mm-hmm. And are we going to hear all these on the tour?
Yes.
All the hits.
Yes. Never Can Say Goodbye, too.
Yes.
We're very excited, Pierce. Yes. We're very excited because there's so many songs, right, guys? Yes. We're picking through so many things. There's songs that my God, that we know, like Looking Through the Windows, that we performed with Michael, and now we're doing it now.